With yet more people appearing in court in Brisbane today after yesterday's arrests in the streets, the dispute over land rights and the government's attitudes doesn't look like going away.
We have proven the fascists in the Queensland government to be wrong. We've proven that we as people are capable of making our point in a peaceful and dignified manner.
Watching it on TV, you'll only see it once. If you write a song about it, it's on radio all the time. When I started the band, I said, we're not going to be political, because we're not into politics. We play music.
In the story, a group of people sitting in a park, drinking in harmony, drinking until dark.
When I put out Brisbane Blacks, I think they were... He just turned the whole show around.
Now!
What do you want?
Land rights!
When do you want them?
Now!
What do you want?
Land rights!
When do you want them?
The so-called drunken blacks. They know that they've done no wrong. But the pressure from society is strong.
Unbelievable, you know, what went on in this so-called democracy. Like, and as a black fellow at the bottom of the pile, you know, you were fighting uphill all the flaming weight.
Every citizen of Queensland looks to the police force for three main reasons: the protection of life and property, the detection and prevention of crime, and the preservation of good order.
It is necessary for the policeman of today to understand the motivation behind human behaviour.
And something like Commonwealth Games, that's supposed to be an event of international goodwill. And to bring them to a corrupt, stinking centre like Brisbane, Queensland, it was an insult to sensitivities, I think, of a lot of people, not just Aboriginal people.
I wrote Brisbane Blacks for community awareness, you know, to let the white people know what we have to struggle through, you know.
Every day, each passing day, our culture slowly dies, like a piece of paper thrown onto a fire. His ancient weapons now is our only trade. Compared to all the immigrants, look how much we
made. Old Mop one day asked me, he said, why don't we get him to start a band and be serious about it, sort of thing, you know. So we actually started like that and done some gigs around Brisbane. All of us in our band, in the band, we all grew up on missions and controlled settlements or communities.
Most of the fellas in the band, we were all brought up the same way. We knew what it was like to struggle.
Mop and the Dropouts were just there.
People loved them, from up the other side of Cairns all the way down the coast and inland. People love Mop and the Dropouts.
You look down through your noses to see the black man groveling down at your feet.
In a sense, they form like a centre point musically that other people could bloody well emulate or learn from, you know. They stood their bloody ground.
Well, hello, Murrays, Curries, Nungas and Lungas. And this next song I'd like to introduce is to all of my brothers and sisters.
There was a need for our voice on radio here. in the media, somewhere where we could present our perspective on issues, sometimes somewhere where we could play our own music.
The radio is important because it allows us, as Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people, to articulate our own struggles.
Hello people, welcome to Murray Hour. The two introduction songs were the Kookaburra Song from Bamiyal and one from Dennis Conlon and the Magpies called Brisbane Blacks. Incidentally, Dennis Conlon and the Magpies are now known as Mopping the Dropouts.
But I used to just walk down with the guitar down to the studio at Queensland Uni there with Rossi, and he'd set the bloody quarter inch tape going, and I'd just sing a bloody song live on the radio, and he'd tape it, and then they could play it.
Rossi really pushed to get airtime for Indigenous people.
In any society, in any community, media is an essential service. In our community, it's even more of an essential service because the mainstream media is so geared towards serving politics and business.
Wasn't real good at all in the 70s here in Brisbane. The positive side of it was a time of mobilisation.
It brought all people that were sort of confronting this bloody regime together. So you had single mums, you had lecturers, you had bloody blackfellas, you had everybody that was dissatisfied with the political climate coming together. And it built.
It was an amazing scene. Musgrave Park in 1982 for the Commonwealth Games protest. It was fantastic. Mopping the Dropouts was down there playing. We brought up a truck and a PA system and a set of lights.
Now it's time for them to sleep, and it's not in the bed, but in some warm surroundings, in a park or in a shed. It's been drunk through the day, warmed only by the grog, the killer.
Always come down to alcohol. I said, it's not only alcohol, there's a lot of other issues. When you come down here, you know, getting out of Cherbourg, there it was very hard to adapt. And we carried a Cherbourg tag with it ever since we left there. All around the place, you know, we're playing down Victoria, we tell everybody, you know, we're from Cherbourg. Cherbourg very well known for its toughness. And they take no shit from nobody. Do we? I think that's where we get the inspiration from.
Yep.
Because of the old greats that was there. You know, if they can do it, then we can do it too, you know?
I've been around singing and dancing with my people throughout the night. Me and the brothers still going strong. I hear voices of my fathers calling me. Dance, brothers, dance. Don't stop dancing just because you don't see me anymore. I will not.